Dear students, welcome to all of you. Okay, today we will see the problem number 2. Okay, a simple F12 heat pump for space heating. Okay, problem belongs to heat pump. For space heating, and this heat pump operates between the 15 and 50 degrees centigrade temperature limits, and this heat pump required to be pumped is 100 megajoule per hour. 100 megajoule per hour, that is the heat pump capacity, and determine dryness fraction of F12 enters the evaporator. Dryness fraction of F12 we have to calculate, the mass flow rate of refrigerant we have to calculate, the discharge temperature of compressor we have to calculate, and specific heat of vapor we have to, the present problem given, that is 0.8 kilojoule per kilogram, theoretical piston displacement of the compressor, and theoretical power required to run the compressor we have to calculate, and COP of the system. And for this we have to use the properties of the F12 refrigerant. Okay, the properties is given at 50 degree centigrade temperature limit and 50 degree centigrade temperature limit. And pressure also given 4.90 and 12.19. And liquid enthalpy HF value is given at both operating temperature limits, that is 50.1 and 84.9 kilojoule per kilogram. And liquid enthalpy value is given 193.8 and 206.5 kilojoule per kilogram. And liquid entropy value also given, that is 0.1915 and 0.3037 at both operating temperature limits. And last one is vapor entropy. This one is vapor entropy value. This is SG value, this is SF value, and this one is vapor enthalpy, and that is HG value. Okay, and previously we discussed one problem. That problem belongs to only the dry saturated vapor after compression, and this problem belongs to dry saturated vapor at inlet of the compressor. If you draw the pH and TS diagram for this problem, that is look like this pH diagram. Dry saturated vapor at inlet of the compressor we have to draw. In pH diagram, entropy value changes. Okay, in the 1 to 2 process, entropy value changes, and after compression, we are reducing the temperature in the condensation process. After that, isenthalpic expansion process up to 0.4 and 4 to 1 constant pressure heat rejection in the evaporator. The present given condition is, condition of the problem is, dry saturated vapor at the entry of the compressor. At 0.1 we are having the dry saturated vapor. At 0.2 we are having the wet vapor. And if you see the TS diagram for this type of ECR cycle, entropy is constant. The 1 to 2 process, entropy is constant, and after that constant pressure heat rejection takes place. After that we are decreasing the temperature as well as pressure in the isenthalpic process. In the isenthalpic process, entropy changes, so we have to represent with the inclined line. And 4 to 1 process. okay, and this is superheating coil 3 to 4. Okay, you can enlarge this diagram also. In the 1 to 2 process, isentropic compression, 2 to 3 constant pressure, heat rejection in the condenser, and 3 to 4 constant isenthalpic entropy. And saturation curve also you can represent like this, saturation curve. Okay, the present problem is after compression we are having the superheating vapor, and before compression we are having the trisaturated vapor. And here one more change we have to represent, that is the isentropic compression process, entropy is constant. This is 1 to 2 process. Okay, in the isentropic compression process, entropy is constant. Okay, in that manner you have to draw the pH and TS diagrams. With the help of pH and TS diagrams, you have to evaluate the enthalpies at every point in a cycle. I will take only one, that is TS diagram. Okay, in the TS diagram, entropy is constant, 1 to 2 process, and in 2 to 3 constant pressure heat rejection, in the isenthalpic process entropy changes, 3 to 4 process. I will take TS diagram to evaluate the performance of the VCR system, and H1 is equal to the HG1. Similarly, as previous problem, you have to evaluate the enthalpies at every point in a cycle. Okay? Point 1 is on the saturation curve. That means HG1, that is equal to the, from the property table, 0.1 lies at 50 degrees centigrade temperature line. 15 degrees centigrade temperature line, Hg value. What is Hg value at 15 degrees centigrade? Hg value, that is 193.8. Here 15 degrees and here 50 degrees. Okay, 193.8 kilojoule per kilogram. And H2 value is superheated enthalpy. And here H2 dash is trisaturated enthalpy. In order to calculate the enthalpy at H2, you have to add Hg2 dash plus specific heat of gas into T superheating minus T saturation. And Hg2 dash, entropy, enthalpy at 0.2 and enthalpy at 0.2 dash. Enthalpy at 0.2 dash is Hg, that is saturated enthalpy, and enthalpy at 0.2, that is superheating enthalpy. And the superheating enthalpy is sum of saturated enthalpy plus this small quantity of enthalpy. This small quantity of enthalpy you have to add to the saturated enthalpy at 0.2 dash. Okay, the saturated enthalpy value directly you can take from the book. Directly you can take from the property table. And the superheating enthalpy, superheating temperature you have to calculate from the isentropic relation. S1 is equal to S2 relation.
Okay, in the S1 is directly you can take from the property table, that is SG1. S1 is equal to SG1 and S2 is equal to SG2 dash plus ln of Cp into T superheating divided by T saturation. SG values at 0.1 and 0.2 you can easily take from the property table at respective temperatures. SG1 at 15 degree centigrade property lines and SG2 at 50 degree centigrade temperature line. And T superheating you have to calculate from this relation. In this relation you have to calculate the T superheating. SG1 and SG2 values and saturation temperature, that is, okay, at 0.2, that is saturation temperature is 50 degrees. Okay, in this relation, T saturation is equal to 50 degrees centigrade, 50 plus 273, 323 Kelvin, and T superheating we have to calculate, and SG1 and SG2 values you have to take from the property table. Okay, SG1 value is, what is SG1 value from the property table? See, the property table at 0.1, SG1 value is entropy, superheating entropy, that is 0.6902. SG2 value is 0.6797. These two values you have to substitute. 0.6979, 0.6706 kilojoule per kilogram Kelvin. SG1 and SG2 values you have to substitute in this relation. You can get superheating temperature value, that is 327 Kelvin. Okay, this calculation you have to do in your notebook by substituting the SG1 and SG2 dash values. SG1 value is 0.6979 from the property table. SG2 dash value you have to take at 50 degree centigrade SG value, and if you substitute you can get T superheating temperature. After calculating this T superheating temperature, you have to substitute the superheating temperature in this relation to evaluate the H2. Okay, you have to substitute T superheating temperature. Except the superheating temperature, all are known values. HG2 dash value is known value. Specific heat of gas is known value. Saturation temperature is known value. Saturation temperature is 50 degree centigrade. Similarly, and specific heat of gas is given in the present problem, that is 0.8, and HG2 dash value also you can take from the property table. At 50 degree centigrade value, HG value is 206.5 value is HG2. This one is HG2 dash. Okay, that HG2 dash value you have to use in this relation to calculate the H2. After calculating the H2, you have to use that H2 value in order to evaluate the performance of the VCR system. And later H3 is equal to H4. H3 value is liquid enthalpy, and that liquid enthalpy you have to take from the property table at 50 degree centigrade temperature line. At 50 degree centigrade temperature line, okay, HF value is 84.9. Okay, that 84.9 you have to take as H3 is equal to H4. And in this relation, H4 is equal to HF4 plus X4 into HG4 minus HF4. HF value at 15 degrees, these properties you have to take 15 degrees centigrade temperature line gives the HF value, HG value, and in this relation X4 is unknown value. In place of H4, you have to substitute the H3 value. Later unknown value is only X4. Okay, that X4 value you have to calculate. That X4 value is 0.24 is the X4 value. Okay, in that manner you have to evaluate the X4. And later with the help of X4, you have to calculate the H4. So, up to now, we calculated H1, H2, H3 and H4. Okay, in the cycle, in the VCR cycle, all are known enthalpies. 1, 2, 3, 4. All points, enthalpies, we know, that is H1, H2, H3, H4. Okay, with the help of these 4 enthalpies, we can easily evaluate the performance parameters of the VCR system. Okay. First parameter is mass of refrigerant, 0.25 kilogram per second. That parameter we have to evaluate first. Mass of refrigerant, how do we calculate? In the present problem, in the given data, it is given, that is refrigerator capacity or refrigeration effect is equal to 100 megajoule per hour. We have to convert that 100 megajoule into kilowatts per hour, 3600. Okay, if you get 27.8 is kilowatt, 100 megajoule, we are converting into joules and hour into seconds. 27.8 kilowatt is the refrigerator capacity or refrigeration effect. And that refrigeration effect 27.8 is equal to the mass of refrigerant into H2 minus H1. In previously we calculated the H1 and H2 values, and if you substitute that H1 and H2 values here, you can get mass of refrigerant. That mass of refrigerant value is 0.25 kilogram per second. Previously we calculated the H2 and H1. If you substitute the H2 and H1, you can get easily mass of refrigerant. That is our first finding parameter. Okay, later X4 we have to calculate. In previously we discussed how do we calculate the X4 with the help of H3 is equal to H4 relation. H3 value is known value. In place of H4, you have to substitute HF4 plus X4 into HG4 minus HF4. Okay, in this relation X4 we have to calculate. Okay, in that manner, first we have to evaluate the mass of refrigerant. And the next second calculating parameter is X4, and third calculating parameter is superheating temperature, and fourth calculating parameter is X4. Okay, after that, next one is theoretical displacement. Okay, mass of refrigerant into specific volume. Theoretical displacement of the piston is equal to the mass of refrigerant into specific volume. This specific volume value we have to take at inlet of the compressor. Specific volume of the vapor refrigerant we have to take at inlet volume of the compressor. That is at point 1 VG1. That is VG1. Okay, mass of refrigerant already we calculated that one. Okay, that is 0.25 into specific volume also we have to substitute here. That is 0.35. You can get the displacement, theoretical displacement or volume, that is 0.528 meter cube per minute. Okay, next one is theoretical power required. Next parameter is power, mass of refrigerant into H2 minus H1. H2 and H1 values and mass of refrigerant we calculated, and we have to substitute that parameters H2 and H1 also. We can get the power required to run the compressor, that is 4.075 kilowatt. Next parameter is COP of the VCR system, and COP of the VCR system is refrigeration effect divided by work input. Refrigeration effect is equal to H1 minus H4 and work input is equal to the H2 minus H1. If you substitute the enthalpies here, we can get the COP of the system, that is 6.82. Okay, in that manner you have to solve the present problem. Okay, I will repeat again, please listen. Okay, in the present problem, the operating temperature limits are 15 degrees centigrade and 50 degrees centigrade. And the capacity of the refrigerator is given 100 megajoule per hour, and dryness fraction of freon also given. Dryness fraction of freon at entry of the evaporator we have to calculate, that is X4, first parameter, and the mass flow rate of refrigerant we have to calculate, that is second parameter, and third one is discharge temperature of the compressor, that is third parameter. Specific heat of vapor is given. And theoretical piston displacement of the compressor we have to calculate, that is fourth parameter, and theoretical power fifth parameter, COP of the system. And first parameter, dryness fraction of the freon, that is we calculated X4, and mass flow rate of the refrigerant by capacity of the refrigerator, with the help of capacity of the refrigerator we have to evaluate. And second parameter, third parameter is discharge temperature, that is superheating temperature. And fourth parameter is volume, swept was cylinder volume, and fifth parameter is power. Okay, with the help of mass flow rate of refrigerant and enthalpy difference, we have to evaluate the power required to run the compressor, H2 minus H1. With the help of this data, we have to calculate the following parameters. And for that, the problem freon refrigerant properties given in the table. At respective temperatures, operating temperature limit, that is 50 degrees centigrade and 50 degrees centigrade, and liquid enthalpies and liquid entropies, and liquid enthalpies and entropy values at that respective temperatures are given, and in case of pH and TS diagrams, okay, if you draw, okay, like this you have to draw in your notebook, and with the help of TS and pH diagrams only you have to solve the present problem. Okay, this is PV power gamma is equal to constant, and this is pressure is equal to constant, pressure is equal to constant, this is enthalpy is equal to constant. Next one. Okay, first H1 value directly we can take from the property table. Why? Because H1 is equal to HG1, HG2. 0.2 enthalpy we have to evaluate by using the relation HG2 plus specific heat into T superheating minus T saturation. For this, we don't know about the superheating temperature. That superheating temperature we have to evaluate from the S1 is equal to S2 relation. S2 is equal to HG2 dash plus specific heat of gas into ln of T superheating divided by T saturation. And with the help of this relation, we are calculating the superheating temperature. After calculating the superheating temperature, we can easily evaluate the H2. And H3 is equal to H4 relation, isenthalpic process, 3 to 4 process. H3 value, we can easily take from the property table. And H4 value, we are taking from the relation. H4 is equal to HF4 plus X4 into HFG4. After calculating the H4, okay, we will calculate the mass of refrigerant by using the capacity of the refrigerator. After calculating the mass of refrigerant, we are calculating the power required to run the compressor, that is mass of refrigerant into H2 minus H1. And theoretical displacement, we are calculating based on the relation, that is mass flow rate into specific volume of the inlet of the compressor at point 1, that is 0.35, and mass of refrigerant is 0.25, and power required to run the compressor we can calculate, and COP of the system we can calculate. In that manner, we have to solve the present problem. Next class, we will see the one more problem. Thank you.